NIMH's mission is to transform the understanding and treatment of mental illnesses through basic and clinical research, paving the way for prevention, recovery, and cure. But some people may not know that many of the most important medical advances trace back to basic research aimed simply at understanding the brain.
Basic science, both neuroscience and behavioral science, are helping to understand about the genes, cells, molecules, and circuits, and the behaviors that go awry in serious mental illnesses.
At NIMH, we're currently funding hundreds of projects. They're all aimed at understanding something fundamental about how the brain works and how it develops, that when we put it all together, will enable the development of new treatments and cures, ultimately giving patients hope for a better future.
There's a couple of novel technologies that we are incorporating in our research. For example, we now, in the field of neuroscience, have the ability of monitor the activity of individual neurons in real time. In addition, we're actually able to also modulate the activity of these neurons using a technology called optogenetics, and this is a tremendous technique that has created a revolution in neuroscience and has given us access to address questions that we previously didn't think we were able to address.
The thalamus is a small structure right in the center of your brain that we've known for a long time, since I was a graduate student, that it's involved in relaying information from your eyes, from your ears, to your cerebral cortex, the wrinkly part on the outside of your brain. But it turns out from new findings that it's serving the role like an orchestra conductor in terms of keeping the signals in tune and in time with each other.
One of the projects that we're supporting is to find biological markers, which are clinically meaningful measures in people that can help us understand autism spectrum disorder. We're looking at brain signatures. We're also looking at eye tracking measures that reflect social interactions between individuals. And by seeing how these markers separate individuals into subgroups, we can more easily find out what possible interventions will be effective.
The most surprising thing that I found about my research is how effective light at influencing us, not only for our ability to see images, but also for affect our major behaviors, including sleep, our biological clock, our mood, our learning and memory. We need light for some reason to improve our behavior and our functions. And we're trying to understand why do we need this light information to reach our brain.
Sometimes findings from basic research translate quickly into practical applications, but even advances that don't immediately lead to new treatments provide the knowledge on which future treatments will be based. The path to prevention, diagnosis, and treatment for mental disorders starts with basic science.